Carl from Carl's Crafts. Welcome back if you've been before. And hi, if this is your first time, this is where I video my whip and chat, which tells you all about what's been happening in the Witherington household or what might be happening. I divulge all here. So welcome. I've got my starlight candle lit for anybody that needs prayers, thoughts or positivity. Know that there's always a candle lit in our house for you. I'm just putting it on the workbench behind. We are working on, in case anybody's new, Bubblegum Spaniel by Mary Lyon Kazanov, and it is a 16 by 19 or 41 by 48 centimetres from Diamond Art Club. I'm working out of my Harbour Freights. I have my Shiny Shazza tray and ones I've had off Amazon. I've got from Diamond Painting Pen Shed on Facebook, a Rachel Ray cover minder, a Cal's cup of tea. Oh, gasping I am. So right, what? Oh, should we zoom in? Do you want to zoom? Should we zoom you in a bit so you can actually see what I'm? Can we zoom in a bit more? There we go. Yeah, right, let me pull the paper back so you can actually see what we're doing. I'm going to be working on the glasses, I think. I've got that bit of wood block you just see to stop my paper sliding down because I've got it dangling over the table. Hang on, we need to move that up. So there's that, my little thing, my little doodahs. Yeah, we're all in now, I think. Can we go in a bit closer? Will it focus if I go in any closer, though? Doesn't want to focus properly, does it? But you can see where I'm going. You can see where I'm going, can't you? Oh, that was a scrape on it. Right. Let's have a look. We'll do some number nines. So it's a number nine, number nine, number nine is a number nine. Okay. So I'll put some of them in there just to start off. Well, it is absolutely gorgeous day here today. It's about 21 degrees. It's probably, if you're out in the sun, it's probably about 30 degrees. If you're in the shade, it's, well, in the shade in our garden, it's 24, I think Millie said. But the, you know, forecast says 21, but in the shade it's 24 in our garden. And it's a lot hotter if you go out in the sun. No wind. So it's nice, I'm not going to complain. This is Wales, you don't get warm sunshine very often. So gotta make the best of it when you can. Oh, it does help if I put wax in, doesn't it? Peoples, why didn't you remind me, peoples? Right, I need a needle. Just pull it all out. So you just literally get a pin in the end, get the old wax out, and you can tell it's old, look, because it's like gone black on the end. I haven't used this pen for quite a while. That's why I decided I'd have a go at using it. I've got some old Diamond Art Club wax that I've been using for a while. So just poke it in there. And hopefully I've got enough in there. And then off to go, there we go. Then we can start popping them in. As you can see, I've done quite a bit. I'm up to its glasses, which is pretty good for me. We won't mention how long we've been doing it. Nah, we won't mention. Because it has been quite a while, hasn't it? But we've been doing it, but it doesn't matter, does it? You lot don't mind. I thought today I'd do this one. I did think, should I get Gemini out again? I thought no, because I'll be doing that tomorrow in the live. So let's do a little bit on the spaniels. She's been neglected. Oh, have I seen some lovely little puppy dogs this week. Been going up to our local lake. And because it's been nice this week. Even though when it's been overcast, it's been pleasant enough to go for a walk. So been going up the lake for a walk and taking the dog. And of course everybody else has the same idea. There's loads, been loads of puppies. There was a little grey and white collie. There was an 8-week-old cockapoo called Oscar, who wanted to make friends with Lily but was too scared. So Lily was gentle with him, but yeah, he was a bit of a scaredy cat. And there was a black Labrador. I think that was 10 weeks old. And then today we saw another black Labrador, which was probably younger. It didn't look very old at all. So I'm guessing about 8 weeks. Plus, you know, the full grown dogs as well. Loads and loads and loads. Every variety you can think of. Everybody was out, but me and the girls did check the concrete today because it's hot, to make sure that the concrete wasn't too hot for her to walk on. And we didn't walk all the way around the lake, which is about just over a kilometre, because the far side can get quite hot. So we did the smaller walk today, which was just under a kilometre with her, which she didn't mind because she got a puppy ice cream. They do special dog ice creams there. So me and the girls had an ice cream. Ha ha, had strawberries and cream ice cream. Millie had, oh God, Buono, is it? One. And Jessie had Maltesers one. And I have to say, they were very nice. They weren't sickly. I find a lot of ice cream sickly. So I don't have ice creams very often because they make me feel sick. But these were really nice. And the bloke that's taken over this little cafe, and well, it's not a cafe, it's like a little coffee place that says ice cream and gifts, like a gift shop sort of thing. And he's brought the boats back because we haven't had boats on the lake for, God, donkey's years. So he's brought the splash cats back, have come back. He's got kayaking for the first time for probably 40 years of any type of boating like that. So that's back on, and there was loads on there today. Yesterday we went up with my sister to meet my sister. She came over from... Sorry, I'll put that on. I do apologise, I haven't put it on silent. She came up from Bochard, where she lives. So their two carers came up with her yesterday. So, because Millie was off, she came up as well, took the dog, because she loves seeing the dog, and Dad. We sat there and had a coffee. It was a bit drizzly yesterday, so we sat under the big canopy, so she was nice and dry in the wheelchair. And then Millie wanted to do a roller skate, so we had a coffee with Auntie Jacqueline, and then I took Millie and took the dog for a walk while Millie roller skated round. So that was nice. So they took a picture, which they're going to send us, of us together. So I really enjoyed that, even though it was a bit drizzly and wet, but it was still warm. But it was so nice. And I don't get to see Jacqueline an awful lot. You know, and she looks so nice, bless her. She had her hair cut and it's gone wavy. She's always had straight hair. But for some reason, it's she's got older now. It's gone wavy. And they've had it cut short and it really suits her. And they've dyed it brown because she's quite grey. And she looked bloody lovely, she did. You know, put a blanket on her in the chair because she sometimes can get a bit cold in the wheelchair. But yeah, it was nice. She enjoyed it, and they got her a little ice cream and fed her an ice cream in the little cup thing, which, because all her food's pureed and her drinks have got to have big thickeners in and stuff. So ice cream she can eat because it is soft and, you know, doesn't have to have thickener and stuff in it. So I suppose she enjoys it because it is as it. You eat it as it's meant to be eaten, you know, because like any other food, she's going to have puree, bless her. But it was nice, even though she doesn't communicate or whatever. She did point to the ducks because there's loads of swans up. Well, there's two swans that have got, there's loads of swans up there, but there's two swans that have got babies. The one's got three and the other one's got four. And then I think there's three or four sets of ducks, baby ducks up there as well. And you've got the Canadian geese, and then there is another type there, but I don't know what type that is. They're little, like little tiny ones. So she was fascinated watching all them. And the dog just sat there and quite calmly and just took it all in. Wasn't bothered by any of it. So he took, when I was walking around though, Millie was in front and back, and I'm trying to train her not to go in front of me. I know she's six and she can't do it, but Grant lets her go on the big lead. Well, I can't have her on the big lead and pull him because she'll pull me over. So I said I need her to stand by the side of me. And I had got her near enough there, but of course Grant's been taking her out, and of course he teaches her bad habits. So I've had to put her back on a short lead and have her walking next to me. But I said to him, otherwise I'm not going to be able to take her out, you know, because I won't be able to hold on to her. Bless, but she was good as gold. She walked around the lake. She went past all the fishermen and not bothered. And then we went past this one fisherman. Oh, my bloody God. I don't know what it was about this fisherman, but she started snarling and barking, and he was smiling at me. I said, oh, she probably thinks she got a fish, she said. I think she's trying to tell you she wants your fish. And he was laughing. And I was thinking, oh, my God. I don't know. She took a dislike to this one. So, quickly as I could. Hobbled as quick as I could past him. And then the next fisherman, she was fine. Nothing. So I don't know. Yeah, very odd. But I trust her instincts, so I stayed away. We kept walking, as they say. Millie found it a bit more difficult on her roller skates because she's not been out in the wet on them before. And she said the roller bits of it are indoor, outdoor ones. So you've got to be on flatter ground. Well, there was a lot of little bits of twigs and God knows what rubble and stuff, and the pavement was a bit bumpy and with the wet on it. But she didn't go down. She had a few wobbles, but she didn't go down, bless her. So I was quite chuffed for her. Yeah. So we had quite a few pleasant days up the lake. I said I might go up there tomorrow if it's nice again with the dog. Just such a pleasant place to walk around. You know, we're lucky to have it on a doorstep, so you need to make full use of it. You know, but talking of the lake, Millie wants a little job now. She's not in school, and where this lake is, there is a cafe that's sort of upstairs above the gift shop. So Millie went in there today. She's been thinking about going in and asking, see if there's a job. She doesn't really want to be house in front. She wants to be either bottle washing and just taking meals to tables. That's it. That's, you know, she's quite happy being in the background. So I said, well, go on, just go and ask. No. And of course, you know, Jeanette persuaded her today to go up when they'd be quiet, about 3:30. To go in and ask. I said, just go in and say, because she'd filled in an application form online. So I said, well, it just shows you're keen. Just go in and say, look, my name's Millie. I was wondering if you've got any jobs going, even if, you know, whatever, willing to put my hand to anything. And just go and try. Oh, well, she had a bit of a breakdown when we were on our way up there. Didn't think she was doing. So I said, head up, shoulders back. That's it. Wipe the tears and off you go. I said, don't look back. Go on. And she did. She went in. She asked. And she's got a trial run tomorrow at 9:30 till 4:00. And the lady said it'll probably be pot washing and stuff mostly. Millie said, that's fine, I don't mind pot washing, I'm quite happy with that. So she said, just wear a black top and black trousers and a comfy pair of shoes. So I was dead proud of Millie when she came out. She was smiling from ear to ear, but then she went out the wrong door. So she did get, don't go out this door, go out the other, because you have to have an indoor and outdoor now, don't you? So the old outdoor has been nobody's supposed to use, but of course she didn't think, because it's still the old exit. They need to move the exit sign off there. Because the old exit sign was still on there. So she starts tomorrow. So she just tried on their old school black trousers, which she probably hasn't worn, a little bit big. So we found a black belt, small black belt, because she's only tiny. Then she didn't have a black shirt or anything, so we found one of her old brother's black shirts. So I think he only wore it once. It's a little bit big, but when she tucked it into her trousers, and it's a little bit low cut, so I said, we'll put a little pin in there, that'll hide that. But she looks really smart, so she feels confident. And I said, you can put your hair up. She's got to take her nail varnish off. So I had to explain to her why you've got to take your nail varnish. She said, oh, yeah, that makes sense. So she's got to do that. So, yes, I'll have to take her up there for 9:30 tomorrow. Bless her. I said, just take it all in your stride. I said, that's all. If you don't understand something, you just ask. And worst case scenario, she can just come home. Do you know what I mean? But I didn't tell her that bit. Because I want her to do it, because I think it'll do her confidence a world of good. Yeah, so that was good news. And she's had her hair done as well. She had the last lot of bleach went on yesterday. So it's not blonde blonde, but it's not far off on the underneath of her hair. So she's happy with it. She's over the moon with it. So I paid for yesterday as her, because she has her exam results, preliminary exam results on Friday. So I said to her, so I put the money in a bank. And when she finished, she said, why did you do that? And I said, it's an early graduation thing for your exams. I said, because I said, I don't care what results you get. I said, I know that you put your heart and soul into it. You studied hard, you revised hard, you know. So I said, that's your gift. I can't give you the world, but I can pay for your ear to be done. So she was over the moon. So that means what she would have used on her hair, she can use to customize her skates. So I think that's what she'll be doing. Yeah, so she's over the moon. What else has been happening? Oh, Lily's at the bottom of the stairs, absolutely knackered. All this walking she's been doing this week. Oh, she was so cute in the week. Grant was watching one of the horror films. I can't remember what it was. And I was tired. I think it was Monday night. So I said, I'm going up to bed. And I went up to bed about 8:15. And I was shattered. And I must have cutched down about, I don't know, about 9:30 and gone off to sleep. And then, I don't know, about 11. I felt this wet nose on my nose. And then a kiss, wet tongue on my cheek. Fanny Ann had come up. Give her mama a nose button kiss. I looked at her, I said, you all right? She just looked at me, put her head down, turned around and went back down to her dad. So I'm presuming that was her goodnight kiss for me. She'd come up and give me a goodnight kiss, bless her. It was so sweet. Oh, I was really touched, bless her. She's got such a heart of gold. She's finding it harder this hot weather, bless her. And of course, I can't get her into the groomers because I booked her in for August. Why I left it till August? Because her fur hasn't been growing very, very quick. But because I've left it now, yes, it's had a growth spurt. So she's got thick fur. So I said to Grant, we're going to have to get grooming kit offline. I might have a word with Danielle. And just have her give her a... I don't want it... short, but see if we can, what's the one we can just take some of it off for her. But yeah, but never mind. You live and learn, don't you? I should have kept it to 8 weeks, but I didn't. So I thought she hasn't grown much, so. What else? I'm trying to think. Oh yeah, does anybody else in the house, right? There's been a flannel on the side of our bath for nearly 2 weeks. And I've purposely cleaned around it. Because whoever put it there has just left it there. Not picked it up, not moved it, not put it to dry, nothing. Do you think anybody would remove it and put it in the wash basket? Because that's where it should be. Once you use it, you put it in the wash basket. It's not rocket science. Nope. And then there was something at the bottom of the stairs, I left, that was still there. And then I put some drying out the dryer on the bench at the bottom, by my front door. There's like a long bench. So I was going towards the kitchen door and I took it off the dryer and I put it on there and I left that there thinking, I wonder if anybody's going to help me and take them up. Nope. Nobody. Mr. Nobody. It was about all week. Nobody did it. So I had to, didn't I? So I threw the flannel out and gave it all a good scrub where it had been. Bleached it. It did stink as well. You'd think they'd move it, but nope. So I scrubbed all the bathroom then because I felt dirty because I'd left it there. I couldn't leave it there anymore. And I moved the thing that was on the stairs because that was driving me bonkers. Everybody else just walks around it. You know. I'd even put it in an awkward place, but nope, everybody just walks around it. And then I've taken the drying up as well. Because, well, I had to really, because Joshua's come home today. He's brought his massive computer back because he won't need that at the moment for his uni work. So that's come home. So he's come home today and he's going back tomorrow, but he's brought his girlfriend home to meet us. And I have to say, she is lovely. For the bit I have seen of them, they got here about 1 o'clock. We had a chat for about 10 or 15 minutes, unloaded his car, and then they'd gone off to meet all his mates, and then they come back about, I think it was about 4, to fill a water bottle and have a wee and whatever. And then they said, is it all right if we go back out? Might go up the dams or stuff. Or... And I said, yeah, that's fine. I said, you can come and go as you please, Josh. It was just nice that you came and you brought Vicky to meet us. So, yeah, she's a very pleasant young lady. So you must really like her to bring her down. Because we never got to be introduced to any other girlfriends. So, yeah. So that's been quite nice. Yeah, so I had to get the house pretty much clean and tidy because I didn't want her thinking, coming in and thinking, oh my God, they're disgusting. Mind you, Millie did give me a hand this morning. Jessie's busy painting her room. So while she was doing that, Millie helped me. Because she sleeps in Joshua's room when he's not here. So he stripped the bed, took all her stuff back out that she had in there, cleaned all the units and whatever, hoovered, and then my Hoover wouldn't bloody pick up. Oh my God, it's not that old either, my Hoover. But it won't pick up. So I've got a little hand one that I use for the stairs. That ran out of it. Finished the stairs apart from one step and it ran out of battery. So I was going to use that. So I had to finish charging it up, and then I finished the top stairs and managed to get most of what on the floor in the hallway and in his room has it all. I said the rest will have to, she'll just have to take us as we are. I said I can't do no more. I can't fix the Hoover and I can't afford to go and buy a new one. This was, I think this was the trouble with this one, it was only about £70. And you're talking for a good Hoover, you're talking about 400 quid a year in this country for a good Hoover. £300 to £400. Yeah, so that was that. Been an odd week this week, I must admit. As you all know, I suffered... have suffered and do suffer from severe depression. I have done from diagnosed at 9. But I don't know what it is lately. I just can't shake this feeling. You know, like your shoulders are being weighted down. And everything seems to get on top of me. And, you know, you're still smiling through. And I'm one that I like the explanation for things. I need to know the reasons why. And when I can't know the reasons why, it sends me into a spiral. And there's quite a few things that are going on at the moment that I can't find the answers to, which I find extremely hard. You know, and I can't answer some of Millie's questions as well, which I find hard as well. But yeah, so I apologise. I put a post up. Well, I don't apologise because that's how I felt at the time. About subscriber counts. I know you shouldn't count subscriber counts. You shouldn't monitor it. And I don't usually. Since the last time it went pear-shaped, I haven't bothered. Really, even if they've been going up and down. I notice them going up and down because I have to go... I go on Studio to check my comments because they don't come up on... Nothing tells me that I've had a comment. So somebody's commented on a video. So unless I go into every single video all the time, I can't find who's commenting. So I go into Studio and it lists what comments have come up. And of course, when you go on Studio, the first thing that's greeted you is your subscriber count. And I know... I shouldn't have made it worried, but I put a video up for ones who don't know, and then within, it was a colouring video, flip through, and then within 30 minutes, four or five people, I can't remember, had unsubscribed within 30 minutes. Now, that never happens. Yes, I lose subscribers, one or two a day every now and again. Sometimes in a week, you can lose, you know, quite a few, but it's usually not in 30 minutes space. And then the rest of the day, I think I lost another four. I think 10 in that day I lost. No idea why. Hadn't lost any the day before. I haven't lost any today. But yeah, but that day. So, because I was on a downer, of course it got to me. You know, you think, what have you done wrong? Why don't people like me? Why are they all unsubscribed just with this one video? And then I had all you lot telling me off, saying, don't look at the count. And I know I shouldn't. No, I shouldn't. But I think I said, like Grant said, he said, I know why it's hit you hard, because that four or five that you lost straight away is what you normally, is the only amount that you get in a week. Because I'm lucky if I get 20 subscribers in a month. Mostly I get probably 12 or 13 subscribers if I'm lucky in a month. Like, I know most of you get about 200 or more or 400 subscribers a month, but yeah, that's not me. I'm lucky if I get 12 a month. So when you lose 10 in one day, that's a lot. But yeah. But I'm all right today. I was all right the day after. I just thought, oh, fucker. Pardon my language. Do apologise if anybody's offended, but that's how I felt. I thought, I am me. I can't be anything else. I'm not false. I can't be false because I can't keep it up. I ain't, and my memory's shot. Do you know what I mean? Gotta have a damn good memory to be false. I can't be arsed with it either. You know, I am what I am, as they say. And I can't make an apology for it because, you know, that's the way I'm made. So, yes. So, yeah, that was a little blip. And we all get little blips. So, say, most of the time it doesn't bother me. And then every now and again. And it is really, if you had to unsubscribe, you say it's because, oh, I find that boring, I don't like it, blah, 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 fine. That's okay. It's the fact that you don't know why people are in one big chunk. And I did say to Grant, because I said to him last weekend, I said, oh, I've had a little flurry. I think I'd had six in 4 days. No, seven, that was it. Seven things, subscribers in 4 days. And I said, I bet you next weekend, I said, or the end of the week, I said, it'll go pear shape and they'll all go and more. Joking, because I didn't really think that would happen. Should have read my own words, didn't I? But never mind. So yeah, so I said to Grant, what will be will be. You know, the ones that matter are there, and I thank each and every one of you that keep coming back. And Grant did say to me, he said, are you a miserable cow on there or something? I said, oi! I said, I'm not miserable, am I? He said, well, you can be a bit miserable. I said, with you, I can. You're a pain in the arse. I said, but I don't think I am. I said, yeah, I said, I'm truthful. I said, I whip and chat. I tell him as it is. I tell him things that happen. I can't see the point in lying, you know. I don't make out that things are rosy and all bloody sparkle when they're not, because that isn't life. And if people say their life is perfect and everything is going rosy, posy, cozy, then I'm sorry, I don't believe it. You know, well, it might be if they're stinking rich and can afford everything and everything done for them, but then I don't believe it. You know, we all have good days, we all have bad days, we all have indifferent days, and we all have horrendous days, but you know, you are what you are. And I say, I think I'm quite funny at times, but it depends if you like my sense of humour, whether you find me funny. Grant just looks at me. I said, well, I don't think I am. I said, I think people enjoy watching me. He said, oh, okay then. I said, you've heard me make the videos and stuff. He said, oh, you always seem quite jolly and, you know, say as it is. I said, well, there you go then. So then he got me wondering then, am I a miserable old cow? Am I laughing thing? But I don't want to be false. I can't be one of these, you know, I'm not going to be start doing the bloody telling jokes and all this sort of stuff. I said, you know, I said I'd tell funny little stories or something that's happened or something I find funny or, you know, but that's about it. Anyway, I'm rambling on now, aren't I? Rambling a load of shite, as they say. I'm still waiting for my Windsor Diamond Art painting to come in. I'm getting a bit fed up now because it's over nine weeks since I've ordered it. And it's supposed to be a British company. I obviously get it from abroad because everybody else that I've ordered for has come in less than that. I've emailed them and have I had a response? Nope. So I will be emailing them again Monday. I don't think I'll have time now to do it today or tomorrow. So I'll email them again and ask them where it is. I know they've got a thing on their front page saying, please be patient due to COVID, blah, 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 blah. But if that's the case, then I think if it goes over 8 weeks, then they should contact you and say, yeah, it's still on thing. You know, we're still on track. Don't worry. It'll be another couple of weeks and you'll get it, but nothing. Again, this boils down to I need to know these things. Now, Craftology, I've ordered, what's it called? Niagara Dancing Lights, Hallow Queen's Vault, because she was doing it on my live on Sunday, and I loved it. I saw this picture, and I absolutely loved it. I was blown away by it. It is gorgeous. I've never seen it. I didn't know Niagara Falls was lit up at night. Beautiful, beautiful thing. So, of course, when I got off my live, I ordered it. And Craftology, I've never ordered off them before. I don't know anything about the company. But they have kept me informed stage by stage by stage of I ordered it Sunday night. Yeah, I ordered it late Sunday night. Monday morning, I had an email to say they'd received my order. Tuesday, I had an email to say they were processing it. Thursday, I had an email to say that it had been shipped. And then yesterday, I have another email saying not to worry, they would contact me when it would be nearer to me. And here was the shipping tracking numbers and stuff. So they've kept me informed all the way. And they're just a husband and wife team. So I don't know. Totally different way, and I'm quite chilled because I thought that's going to take a while for that one to come. But yeah, but I'm looking forward to that one. I'm really looking forward to that one. Although Hallow Queen said there's quite a few 310s, I think. I can't remember if she said 310s or 939s. But that's fine. That's fine. We can cope with that. We can cope with that. We can do a bit of colour blocking, a bit of, you know, bit of confetti, bit of colour blocking, bit of confetti, bit of colour blocking, it'll soon go. You know, so I am excited to get one because I've never had one off them. At the moment they've got, I think it's buy two, get one free offer on the go at the moment. And I was tempted, but I thought, I don't know what their quality is like. I don't know anything about it. So if you know, if you've had a Craftology one, let me know down in the comments, if you would please, what it was like, what you thought of it, what the diamond drills are like, are they nice size, any popping. I think I ordered a round. I think I've been playing it safe lately and just ordering rounds, but I am excited for that one, really excited. There's a couple down there. Yeah, so I'm really, really excited for that to come. I can't wait for that to come. So yeah, I made a few bags this week, which are all new on my Etsy. Oh, I've changed my Etsy name. I did say on my floss tube yesterday. A few people have commented and emailed me and whatever about the name. Some people said they could take offence by it because Winky can be classed as an offensive word in some places. And then somebody else pointed out that somebody who didn't know the reason of the name Winky Wonky might find it a very strange name to have and avoid the shop because of the name. I don't know. So I talked it over with Grant and he said, well, just change it. Because I'm Cal's Craft on YouTube and Cal's Craft on Instagram. But I couldn't have that on Etsy. Because that was obviously already taken, apparently. So what I have done, though, is I've put it as Cal's, capital C-A-L-S, all, capital A, double L, crafts, capital C-R-A-F-T-S. So Cal's, all crafts. Changed it to that, because that was the nearest to my name that I could get. So I will get my stickers changed to that, because I've nearly run out of them anyway. So it's nearest to my Facebook, Instagram and YouTube name. So somebody will probably say they don't like it, but I don't know. That's what I've done, because I can't tell you, because it's all in the making stage at the moment, planning and making. My Patreons will hear about it, because I will can ask them their opinion, but there's going to be something new in the shop if I can pull it off and I can make it, which will be handy for quite a few different crafts. So I'm going to ask my patrons what they think, whether they think I should have a go at doing it or not, or whether it's they think it's a waste of time or not. I don't know. So I'm going to ask them first their opinion. Because I know they'll be honest, and if it's shit, they'll tell me it is, you know. And that's what I need. So I'm going to, hopefully tomorrow, I'm not going to have time today, but I'm going to plan it out and cut the materials out that I need, because I'm not sure what type of materials I'm going to use yet to make this product. And then start experimenting and see what I come up with. I'm quite excited. I've done a bit of research on it as well. So yeah. So Patreons, look out for that. That should come today or tomorrow. I'll be posting that. And give me your honest opinion. And if you don't know what my Patreon is, the link is down below. It's where people get inside information into my channel. There's all different tiers, and you, for all the different tiers, you get different things. So, nobody's obliged to, it's just, you know, it's there if you want to. And then I share videos, private videos, information of what I'm doing and when I'm doing stuff before anybody else gets to know. So, yeah, so that'd be interesting. So Grant's at a craft fair today in Abergavenny. He's done quite good, he said, today. So we're having Chinese for tea as a treat. Which will be nice. Oh, so I said to Josh, you and Vicky coming back, he said no, they'll probably go off because they're only here for a short time. He said they'll probably go off and see the rest of his friends, catch up in there, introduce Vicky to them. I think she's quite nervous to meet them all. So I said, well, we have Chinese, I think, about 5:30, 6 o'clock. And then I said, whenever you come back, well, there's always loads left over, because usually what happens, they have all these different stuff, loads left over. And then the guys have, whoever gets to it first in the morning has first dibs for breakfast. So I said, well, you and Vicky, when you come in, just help yourself to whatever you want. If you want something, if you don't have something to eat when you're out and about. But I'm quite looking forward to that, because it means I don't have to cook. I've only got to lay the table and wash the pots, well, the plates up after, which is fine by me. I can manage that. And I don't think I'm going to do a roast dinner tomorrow, because I think it's going to be sticky and warm like today. So what I might do is do chicken and rice. Do like salad stuff. Cook some chicken thighs or something, shred it, and then either put it in the rice or to the side, and then do rice with sweet corn and peas in it. Maybe some potatoes, I don't know. I have to see what the weather actually is going to be like, because you can never trust the weather forecast in Wales, especially mid Wales, because they say one thing and it can be completely different. So I'll see what it's like in the morning, because I'll have to go shopping for supplies. And then we'll decide then what we're doing. So that's what's been happening this week. I'm going to be stitching up my rainbow project bags now when I get off here. I've prepared the zips and stuff, and I've got all the pieces together, so that's all cut ready. So I've just got to put it all together. It's 5 to 5, so I could probably get the zips and everything fastened together once I put this away, and then the next thing is to do this project to try and work out that. So thank you ever so much for stopping by and listening to me filling you in on my Withington bits that have been happening this week. If you like what you see and you've not subscribed, you might like to subscribe and stick around, because we do, as you see, diamond painting, whips and chats, floss tubes, colouring, lives. And we're going to be dyeing some Aida fabric with coffee and tea. I might do the coffee staining first. I asked in floss tube yesterday, and I have done coffee staining on paper, but I can't remember if I've done it on Aida. But somebody recommended doing coffee or tea to get it the colour I want for the Christmas tree. Which, by the way, if you watched yesterday, it doesn't start on the 1st of July. It starts on the 1st of September. I got that wrong. Mm-hmm. Danielle, contact me. You've got the date wrong. Oh, I said, trust me. What a plonker. Anyway, digressing now. So all my social media information is down below as well, if you want to have a chat or contact me or see what's going on. It's all down below. Patreon links down below. Comment section is also down below if you want to leave a comment and answer some of the questions that I've asked in the video. I would be very chuffed if you did. And there's also a notification button by the side of the subscribe button, which is like a little bell, and that tells you when I go live, which is on a Sunday, and when I upload videos, which is a couple of times a week. So with that said, I'm going to love you and leave you and say look after yourselves, take care, and most importantly, stay safe. Love you all. Bye.